In this segment, we will talk about how can we find eigenvectors of a square matrix. So let's suppose somebody says, hey, find eigenvectors of this matrix right here. 3 minus 1.5 minus 0.75 plus 0.75. So the first thing which we have to understand is that eigenvectors correspond to eigenvalues. So this particular 2 by 2 matrix is going to have two eigenvalues, and corresponding to each eigenvalue will have an eigenvector. So in a previous segment, we have already found out that the two eigenvalues corresponding to this to this particular square matrix is 3.421 and 0.3288. So these are two eigenvalues which we found out in a previous segment. And let's go and see that how we can find the eigenvector corresponding to this eigenvalue. And this one you can then find by yourself. So what we are saying here is that, hey, let then this vector, this column vector, x1, x2, be the eigenvector corresponding to lambda equal to 3.421. So we are saying, hey, let this two rows and one column vector, or this column vector, be the eigenvector corresponding to the first eigenvalue. How do we go about finding that? We already know that that from the definition of the eigenvalues is that, hey, a minus lambda I times x is equal to 0. So if lambda is the eigenvalue of A, then if we subtract lambda times the identity matrix from A and we multiply with the eigenvector, it has to give us 0. So if we do that, what we have now is 3 minus 1.5 minus 0.75 0.75 minus lambda, which is 3.421, then 1, 0, 0, 1, which is the identity matrix, times x, which is x1, x2, is equal to 0, 0. So all I'm doing is substituting the value of A matrix, substituting the value of lambda, and then putting the identity matrix right here, and x1, x2 is the assumed eigenvector, and it has to satisfy this particular set of equations. From there, this is what we get. We get minus 0.421, minus 1.5, minus 0.75, minus 2.671, times x1, x2 equal to 0, 0. And we already know that, hey, x1, x2 equal to 0 is a solution to this particular set of equations, because if I put x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 0, I'll get the left-hand side same as the right-hand side. But what we are looking for is a non-trivial solution. So how do we look for the non-trivial solution is that, hey, let's choose x1 equal to s. If x1 is equal to s, then we get, from the first equation, we get minus 0.421s minus 1.5 x2. Equal to 0. That's what we get from the first equation right here. And from here we'll get x2 is equal to minus 0.2808s. So if that's the case, then we know that the eigenvector corresponding to, so eigenvector corresponding to lambda equal to 3.421, so this was our eigenvalue. So corresponding to this eigenvalue, 3.421, the eigenvector is x1, x2. And we know that, hey, if I assume x1 to be s, some number s, x2 will be minus 0.2808s. So this is the eigenvector corresponding to corresponding to this eigenvector right here. But we said s right there, we can take s to be outside as a scalar, and we get 1 minus 0.2808, So we can consider this to be the eigenvector corresponding to the that eigenvalue. But any if we multiply x1 and x2 by any scalar, that also is an eigenvector corresponding to that eigenvalue. You can also convert this into a unit vector if you want to. That might make it unique in some ways. You still have two possibilities in here because unit vector is based on the magnitude of the vector. All those things can be done later. So we can at least say that, hey, 1 minus 0.2808 is an eigenvector corresponding to lambda equal to 3.421. And you can do the same thing corresponding to lambda 2 equal to 0.3288, which was the other eigenvalue which we had. Corresponding to this, the eigenvector turns out to be 1.781. You can do that as part of your homework, that hey, this is the eigenvector corresponding to this eigenvalue. Corresponding to this eigenvalue following the same procedure, this will turn out to be the one of the eigenvectors corresponding to this eigenvalue. And that is the end of this segment.